an empty pie crust shell, is that what it's called?
It's an empty pie shell. It's not a crust until it's been baked.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, this is pie dough. This is raw pie dough. Once it's been baked, it becomes a crust.
Okay, so hi, Crumb Boss.
Hey, everybody. Crumb Boss here.
Now, before we start, we're making my favorite pie.
Yes, we are.
And let me just share with you guys something, and I'll share with you, Gretchen, why Steph loves this pie. It's not blueberry, it's not whipped cream, it's not pumpkin, because I'm high.
What kind of pie are we making?
Because I'm highly allergic to pumpkin, okay? And it's not any of that. But every time when we had Thanksgiving at my parents' house, one year when I was a little kid, my mom says, why don't you try this pie? And I thought, okay. And I said, let me try it. And it's been my favorite pie ever since. Hmm. And what's it called?
Coconut custard.
Yeah. That's a pie. Let me tell you something. No, that's a real pie, Gretchen, okay? It's not like a pumpkin pie. It's not like a blueberry pie. Blueberry, like, you bite into it, and it's like you're dripping down your face, and cherry is, like, all over you, and you're bleeding. Yeah. And, like, pumpkin, you turn into a pumpkin, for crying out loud.
Coconut custard's an excellent pie. I have to tell you that.
It's amazing.
The least favorite seller in the bakery.
Well, it doesn't, but that, hey.
No, I'm not saying.
I come to the bakery.
Wonderful, but, you know, when.
Well, maybe people will buy it now, because the producer likes it.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. All right, so make. All right, show me how you make the coconut custard pie. I'm so excited.
Wait till you see how easy it is. And we have with us a raw pie shell.
Blue. Okay.
Very easy to make a coconut custard pie. It's basically baking a custard. It's very egg rich, so we've got our eggs here.
Eggs.
This recipe has.
Let me ask you a question. All the chickens in the back of the building.
Man, they're getting worked to death.
I mean, it's like we got the chickens and the cows. I mean, there's so much stuff going on back there. Maybe we should take people back there one day and just to show them what's out back of Woodland Bakery, because we get all our stuff out of the back, right?
Yeah, pretty much. It's a dumpster.
Stomp it. So, my God.
I've got sugar and nutmeg. Nutmeg is one of the ingredients in a coconut custard pie.
What's nutmeg?
Nutmeg is a wonderful spice. It's a fall-flavored spice. Mm. You know, you'll find that whenever there's a recipe for example, lasagna, stuffed shells, manicotti. I'm not Italian, so I actually say it the way it's spelled.
What are
manicotti.
You?
Manicotti. Not manigut.
Yeah, man. Or manigut. You ever go to an Italian person's house for Christmas and they just yell at you? They're like, or you're out to dinner with a bunch of Italian people and they go, hi, I'd like some manicotti. And they all look at you like you just like.
Yeah, yeah, because you didn't say it right.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't get off the boat from Italy yet.
I just say it the way it's spelled. Anyway, we're talking about nutmeg that goes into recipes that are very, you know, like custardy recipes, like a stuffed shell or a manicotti or a lasagna. You'll find that people will put nutmeg.
All right, get going. I want to see you make my pie.
Come on. You don't want to know about nutmeg and how it really spikes up the flavor.
I'm just messing with you.
You don't care about the nutmeg.
I want to see my pie.
You don't care about the nutmeg.
I don't want to see pie smashing. I want to see you make my pie.
Nutmeg, nutmeg, nutmeg.
All right, stop saying nutmeg.
All right.
What is that?
I don't know. Maybe we have a delivery.
Who is it?
Anyway. Okay.
What is that?
It could have been a delivery. I don't know.
Oh.
It happens all the time.
Okay.
Anyway.
What is the sugar?
Sugar. Nutmeg.
Uh-huh.
Vanilla extract was also in here with the eggs and the sugar.
Vanilla extract.
Yeah. I'm now putting in the cream and the milk together.
Let me ask you a question. Yeah. Why don't we just tell everybody something real funny? Yeah. This week it was 102 degrees in New Jersey.
Miserable.
How hot was it in the bakery?
Absolutely
back here?
Miserable. Today we lucked out. And today's got really cool. I was dreading filming today because it was literally.
I know.
Like,
I got like 400 text messages like, Steph, it's going to be hot. Steph, it's going to be hot. So here we go.
Okay, so right now we've got eggs, sugar, nutmeg, vanilla extract, a pinch of salt, milk, cream, and now I'm putting in my coconut.
That's good.
Okay.
Yep. Now, I like coconut. I like coconut water, coconut milk, coconut.
Yeah.
I love that stuff. Now, let me ask you this. You're mixing that up, but what is this? Is this a pie crust? Is it a graham cracker or dough?
No, that's a straight up pie crust.
And how do you get these ridges?
We have a pie press. We have an old-fashioned pie press
nice.
That's like 50 years old.
Yeah, it's like the perfect ridges.
Yeah,
look at that.
So look, I'm pouring that all into here. Now this recipe, I wasn't sure about it, so this actually is going to make two pies.
Two pies.
But we're only making one because I only made one pie shell.
All right.
So yeah, I could probably fill it up a little bit more.
So you fill it up to the top of the the thing. About.
And then you got to be real careful going into the oven.
Okay, so you're going to go into the oven, and we already, our black and white cookies came out of the oven over here. Look at them. Okay, and then we're over here with
we're baking red velvet.
Red velvet's in here, baking away. You see that, ladies and gentlemen? Now, Crumb Boss is going to put the balance, the great balancing act, and put this in.
Be really careful going into the oven.
Oh my God, be careful. Be careful, Crumb Boss. Wow, it's hot. There you go. So, coconut custard pie. That's my pie. Look at that. Red velvet and coconut custard going around and around to bake. Now let me ask you this, Crumb Boss. How long do you bake the coconut custard pie?
That's probably going to bake for like maybe about 25 minutes. You're going to bake it until when you shake the pie, it looks like Jell-O.
Oh yeah.
So it's not like liquidy. Yeah. You know how Jell-O shakes, but it holds its shape. It's going to look just like that.
Let me ask you one question before we go. What's your favorite pie?
My favorite pie is probably, I love pumpkin pie. I love pumpkin pie, chocolate cream pie, coconut custard pie.
I can't eat pumpkin pie, can't eat cranberry.
Key lime pie. Oh, yeah. I love all the kinds. I love everything. Yeah. Everything.
Will you ever have, let me ask you a question. You ever have shoe fly pie? Wait, because they got down in Florida, they got shoe fly pie.
Yeah, when I used to go out to Amish country out in Pennsylvania, they'd have shoe fly pie. That is like so sweet.
Do you know how to make shoe fly pie?
I probably could make it. It's just like a regular recipe.
We should have a shoe fly pie contest and see if the Crumb Boss can make shoe fly pie. What do you guys think? Do you think the Crumb Boss should make shoe fly pie next? Let us know.